Hello, dear students. Today we will discuss about RAD and Agile models, rapid application development and Agile models. These are basically software development lifecycle models. So in this presentation, we will cover introduction, RAD, phases of RAD, advantages and disadvantages, Agile model, phases of Agile and its advantage and disadvantage. So basically, what is RAD? RAD is basically rapid application development. What is rapid? Rapid is basically we go for early development in an incremental manner with focusing on customer feedback at every increment. Okay, so rapid application development is a software development methodology that uses minimal planning in favor of rapid prototyping. A prototyping is a working model that is functionally equivalent to a component of the product. Prototyping is generally partial working of the desired system or project. It basically focuses on gathering customer requirements through workshops or focus groups, early testing of the prototypes by the customer using iterative concept, reuse of the existing prototype, continuous integration and rapid delivery. Okay, so basically it focus on this gathering of customer requirements elicitation, and also it basically focuses on the early testing of the prototypes through the customer feedback using an iterative concept, and along with if the prototype has been approved by the customer, then it is being eventually used in the final system also. Then finally, continuous integration and the rapid delivery is basically achieved in the RAD. Now, basically, what is the difference between traditional and RAD model? Traditionally, we follow the sequential steps in the development lifecycle, like analysis, high level design, detailed design, construction, testing, implementation. But in RAD, we generally follow the analysis of the requirements and making the quick design, and simultaneously building this demonstration, refine and build the prototype. Then we go for testing, implementation, and in this manner we do the development of the software project in an incremental phase manner. For each of the increments, we go for analysis and quick design, then we go for the demonstrate, refine and build prototypes, then we for testing and implementation. Okay, then coming to what are the various phases of RAD, this consists of basically requirement and planning phase, user design phase, construction phase, cutover phase. We will go for each of these phase detail in the subsequent slides. Then coming to requirements planning phase, this is also called a joint requirements planning phase. It basically combines the planning and analysis phases from the waterfall model. So basically the first phase will be just analogous to the combination of the planning and analysis phases. And in this phase also, end users and IT staff agree on business needs, project scope, constraints and system requirements. Means whenever you do the planning and analysis of the requirement, it must be agreed by both the parties, whether it can be client and the developer. Both sides should agree on the project scope. Project scope means the maximum functional and non-functional requirements will be agreed upon by the client and the developer. This phase ends when the team agree on the key issues and obtain management authorization to continue. So basically this phase will end with the final agreed upon the requirements and obtain management approval to continue for that incremental phase of development. Then coming to user design phase, end users and IT staff jointly develop the system, process, inputs and output. They use a combination of joint application design and case tools. Generally, these basically designs are done in an interactive way. Basically, they incorporate the use of joint application design and case tools. This needs to be a continuous interactive process that allows end users to understand, modify, and eventually approve a working model of the system that meets their need. So even in the user design phase, we generally take the feedback from the client by showing the prototype of the design through the tools we are using. And by the tools we are using, the client is able to visualize the anticipated software project. So it needs to be a continuous interactive process that allows end users to understand. This will make them understand, modify, and eventually approve a working model of the system that meets their requirements. Okay. Then coming to construction phase, it is similar to the development phase in the waterfall model. Analogous to the waterfall model, it is just like similar to the development phase of the waterfall model. End users continue to participate and can still suggest changes or improvements as actual screens or reports are developed. Okay, so end user, how they will be able to visualize? If you are designing the front end and showing them, then definitely they will be able to visualize and clearly identify the missing requirement also. So even in the construction phase, we will involve end users. End users means the users which actually use the system on the client side. So they will participate and will be able to recognize the missing or incomplete requirements, if any, because they are just visualizing the actual screens or the reports that have been developed. The key tasks in this phase are basically programming and application development, coding, unit integration, and system testing. So this will accompany the programming. Since this is the construction phase, we have to do the programming after getting the approval of the design also, and then do the coding and unit testing and integration testing by testing the module in isolation, and also the testing the modules when they are combined all together for the purpose of interdependency among the module. Then coming to the cutover phase, similar to the installation, testing, and maintenance phase, as analogous to the waterfall model, including data conversion, testing, and changeover to the new system and user training. So it is just like the testing and deployment phase that we have used in the waterfall model, but it also includes data conversion if it is required at the client side, testing, and also moving or migrating to the new system, which will involve some process to be done, and user training if the end user is of non-IT savvy. Compared with traditional methods, the entire process is compressed, and as a result, the new system is built, delivered, and placed in operation much sooner. Okay, so as comparison to this traditional method, this phase is much faster than the conventional models, and it will be placed in the operation much sooner than any other model. This phase ends up when the team agree on the key issues and obtain management authorization. Because RAD always focuses on the customer feedback, customer approval, then after getting the approval at the cutover phase, then after these steps will be continued for the final deployment. Since RAD is supported by the tools, people, methodology, and the management, we'll discuss how these tools, people, methodology, and management will help in these 4 points. KISS tools, basically computer-aided software engineering tools. I hope you have studied in the software engineering also in the parallel, because you are also studying the software engineering along with the SPM. KISS tools that generate prototypes can be used to support the iterative development approach, allowing end users to see the application evolve as it is being built. The best people, for the people that we have discussed, the best people must be well trained in both the methodology and the tools. Small teams must be grouped together on assignments. A complete list of tasks is provided, means methodology, completely scope task, because we have to pre-plan this, is provided to ensure that no essential activity is overlooked, and while techniques are fully documented to ensure that data task is performed in the proper way. Then for the time box management, means to ensure that the activities must be completed within a specific deadline. So time box management is used in rapid construction to iteratively deliver the system to the user. It is a sub-discipline of project management in which software projects are basically planned, implemented, monitored and controlled. So these are supported by these tools, people, methods and management. Then coming to the advantages of RAD, it significantly reduces development time compared to other models. This approach increases reusability of components, because we have allowed the reusability of the software prototypes that we have developed for the purpose of taking the feedback from the client. Quick initial reviews occur, it encourages customer feedback. Integration from very beginning solves a lot of integration issue. So we do not wait for the increment at the last stage. We will develop in the increments and we finally make the integration. We from time to time make the integration of the various modules or the various increments that we have made. Then coming to the disadvantages of RAD, it depends on a strong team. See, when there is a proper coordination, because RAD is always supported by the tools, people's methods and management. If there is any of the lack, RAD will not be successfully executed. Okay, will not be able to gain the prime objective of RAD. It depends on a strong team and individual performance for identifying business requirements. Only system that can be easily modularized can be built using RAD. If the system is not able to modularize its task, then it cannot be built using RAD. It requires highly skilled developers, designers, because for using tools, they must be conversant with the latest tools and technologies for the rapid development. High dependency on modeling skills. If you are not able to model your particular project either by through tools or the manual, you are not able to utilize the benefit of RAD. Inapplicable to cheaper projects, as cost of modeling and automated code generation is very high. So it does not apply to cheaper projects, as cost of modeling and automated code generation by using the tool is very high. Then applicability of RAD. RAD should only be used if there is high availability of designers for modeling. If the budget is high enough to afford their cost along with the cost of automated code generating tools. Since RAD is supported by the tools, so if there is no such cost to bear the cost of the tools, then definitely you cannot use the RAD. If resources with high business knowledge are available and there is a need to produce the system in a short span of, if there is a requirement of rapid development, then you will use Agile is a term used to describe software development approaches that imply continual planning, learning, improvement, team collaboration, evolutionary development, and early delivery. Agile SDLC model is a combination of iterative and incremental process model with focus on process adaptability and customer satisfaction by rapid delivery of working software product. So agile methods, it will break the product into small increment builds. These builds are provided in iterations. Each iteratively typically lasts about 1 to 3 weeks. Since agile is also iterative enhancement based, okay, so it is a combination of iterative and incremental process model with focuses with prime objective of process adaptability and customer satisfaction by rapid delivery of working software product. So it is also based on basically taking the feedback of the customer at every level with focuses on quality. Since RAD is also just similar like this, but RAD and Agile has the difference. RAD is only focused on the rapid development. Its prime objective for the rapid development. Okay, and requires the discipline and requires the extensive use of tools for the purpose of software development. But in Agile, we generally follow the incremental based approach, and each increment will typically last about 1 to 3 weeks. Then coming to phases of Agile, planning, requirement analysis, design, coding, unit testing, acceptance testing. At the end of the iteration, a working product is displayed to the customer and important stakeholders. Okay, so if any, even at the end of the iteration of any incremental or any increment, a working product is basically displayed to the customer and important stakeholders. If we just view the basically agile model iteration advancement, see, suppose for example, if there is a project consists of 100% development, iteration one can be 33%. You have developed, you have made the planning, requirement analysis, design, building, testing. Then after 2-3 weeks or 2-3 months, whatever may be the case, you will take, after developing the iteration one, you will show to the client, and after making the proper feedback from the client, you will implement iteration number two. And also, if any of the shortcomings that have been addressed in the iteration one will also be addressed in the iteration two and subsequently in iteration three and so on. Then coming to principles of agile model. What are the principles of agile model? Individuals and interactions, self-organization and motivation are important, as are interaction like co-located and peer programming. Okay, then working software, demo working software is considered the best means of communication. So whenever you develop the increments, you should always design the front end user interface or graphical user interface. It is the best means of communication with the customer to understand their missing requirements or any incomplete requirements or any prioritized requirements. Customer collaboration, as the requirements cannot be gathered completely in the beginning of the project due to various factors. Continuous customer interaction is very important to get proper product requirements. Then responding to change, focused on quick response to change and continuous development. Okay, so there should be always be initiative. Whenever there is a feedback for any of the change requirements or for any of the ambiguous requirement, you should always be eager to respond for that to be incorporated in your software development increment. Then coming to the advantages of agile, it is a very realistic approach to software development. It is just not like that it means the rapid delivery, you just have a automated code generation, making the modeling through case tools. Sometimes it may be the risky undertaking. So to remove these disadvantages, agile is doing in a proper realistic fashion. But it promotes teamwork and cross-training. Functionality can be developed rapidly and demonstrated when the resource and also the advantage is basically resource requirements are minimum, since they do not require the extensive costly tools and techniques. Suitable for fixed or changing requirement. When there is a fixed requirement or changing requirements, it is suitable to employ agile model for the purpose of development. Delivers early partial working solution. Good model for environments that change steadily. Inapplicable to cheaper projects. So see here, rapid red is always being for the costly projects. It cannot be used in the cheaper projects because the tools cost are very high. Inapplicable to cheaper projects as cost of modeling and automated code generation is very high. Then minimal rules, documentation easily employed. Disadvantage of agile, it is not suitable for handling complex dependencies. When there is a large dependencies, because since it is developed in the form of increment, so on the software development organization side, they are not able to show the dependency among different modules. So it is not suitable for handling complex dependency, more risk of sustainability, maintainability and extensibility. Okay, because since there is a change requirement after getting the feedback from the users, so there is a more risk of this sustainability, maintainability and extensibility. Strict delivery management dictates the scope, functionality to be delivered and adjustment to meet the deadlines. So proper strict delivery management is also required because every time when the increment is made or every time the iteration is made, you have to discuss with the client, take the feedback. If suppose client is not free to give its feedback, then you have to wait for it. So you have to timely ensure the delivery timeline. Depends heavily on customer interaction. So if customer is not clear, team can be driven in the wrong direction. So since agile depends on the customer interaction, if even the customer is not clear about its requirement, then definitely the development will also go in the wrong direction. Integration from very beginning solves a lot of integration issue. Okay, so any of the integration doing from beginning, it basically solves a lot of integration issues. Transfer of technology to new team members may be quite challenging due to lack of documentation. Okay, so any of the technology to new team members, it may be challenging because there is a minimal amount of documentation in agile model. These are the references that I have followed for the purpose of preparation of this presentation. Okay.